Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their fifth Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 12-4.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their sixth Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Transporter 12.
Lift off of the Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go Transporter 12.
The booster which launched this mission, B1088, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Stage 1 landing leg deployed. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
On Wednesday, SpaceX also successfully launched their seventh Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Blue Ghost Mission 1 and Hakuto R Mission 2. The booster which launched this mission, B1085, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Falcon launches. The next launch, the Starlink 13-1 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 21st at 5:31 a.m. UTC or 12:31 a.m. EST. A few days later and we should see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 11-6 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 24th at 1:54 p.m. UTC or 8:54 a.m. EST. Later the same day and we should see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 10-12 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 24th at 10:45 p.m. UTC or 5:45 p.m. EST. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their seventh Starship mission with the launch of Booster 14 and Starship 33.
3, 2, 1.
Vehicles pitching downrange.
With some incredible views, Starship 33 then successfully separated from Booster 14 with hot staging.
Engines cut off, down to those stage middle separate.
Please back for startup.
All right, hot stage confirmed. We've got a booster hopefully on our way back to us, and a ship now making its ascent burn into space.
Though one of the engines decided to shut down during re-entry, SpaceX attempted and successfully caught Booster 14 with the chopstick catching arms.
Attempting to catch the booster at the tower, this would be the second tower catch.
Booster landing burn.
Seeing 13 engines.
Booster now hovering as it aligns with the tower for catch.
Booster coming in. Down get ready for that boom, Kate.
Down to three engines.
Booster ready for shutdown. Megavore has caught the booster.
You heard it here, Vexilla has caught the booster.
once again, for the second time, a successful catch by the launch tower. This is the same tower, the launch pad, where that booster took off from just 7.5 minutes ago.
Whilst we were all fixated on the spectacular landing of the Super Heavy booster, something bad happened with the Starship 33 vehicle. SpaceX posted saying Starship experienced a rapid unscheduled disassembly during its ascent burn. Teams will continue to review data from today's flight test to better understand root cause. With a test like this, success comes from what we learn, and today's flight will help us improve Starship's reliability. Here's a spectacular slowed down video of the rapid unscheduled disassembly. Though not quite what SpaceX had planned, here's a spectacular video of Starship while what's left of it re-entering the atmosphere. SpaceX posted some epic slow-mo footage of Starship lifting off. They said liftoff of Starship's seventh flight test. The Super Heavy booster utilized flight-proven hardware for the first time, reusing a Raptor engine from the fifth flight test. Musk gave some information pretty soon after the Starship failure on what happened. He said, "Preliminary indication is that we had an oxygen fuel leak in the cavity above the ship engine firewall that was large enough to build pressure in excess of the vent capacity. Apart from obviously double checking for leaks, we will add fire suppression to that volume and probably increase vent area. Nothing so far suggests pushing next launch past next month." SpaceX posted an article on their website with similar information about the Starship Flight 7 launch. They said, "Initial data indicates a fire developed in the aft section of the ship, leading to a rapid unscheduled disassembly. As always, success comes from what we learn, and this flight test will help us improve Starship's reliability as SpaceX seeks to make life multiplanetary. Data review is already underway as we seek out root cause. We will conduct a thorough investigation in coordination with the FAA and implement corrective actions to make improvements on future Starship flight tests." Musk posted some more Starship information. He said the booster flight was a success, the ship flight was quarter successful, hence cut B in around 5/8 full. New ship forward flaps, higher thrust engines and tile adherence on ascent were tested. Improved heat shield performance was the only major thing that wasn't tested, along with the PES payload dispenser, probably solved in next month's launch. The 9-meter diameter version of Starship will probably fly around 10,000 times, so this is barely a bump in the road. There was information posted by Jeff Faust about the FAA requiring a mishap investigation. It says, from the FAA, the FAA is requiring SpaceX to perform a mishap investigation into the loss of the Starship vehicle during launch operations on January 16th. There are no reports of public injury, and the FAA is working with SpaceX and appropriate authorities to confirm reports of public property damage on Turks and Caicos. During the event, the FAA activated a debris response area and briefly slowed aircraft outside the area where space vehicle debris was falling, or stopped aircraft at their departure location. Several aircraft requested to divert due to low fuel levels while holding outside impacted areas. Finishing up the video today, we'll take a quick look at the Cameron County website. SpaceX currently have a couple of temporary closures for today, Sunday 19th, and tomorrow, Monday 20th. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.